Welcome to the online lecture series of environmental science. In the previous lecture, we were discussing about the environmental issues, and some of the issues we already discussed in the previous lecture. Today we will discuss the next issues. Next issue is ozone layer depletion. What is ozone and what are these depletions and how it affects the environment, plants, animals, including human being property? We will have a look on the ozone layer depletion. As we all know, we have atmospheric layers. The lowest layer is troposphere. Next layer is, it extends from the surface up to 16 kilometer, and 16 to 49 kilometer is stratosphere up to 49 kilometer. What we see in this stratosphere, the presence of O3 is very high in the atmosphere, in the stratosphere, and that too is very much high concentration of O3 is present at 25 kilometer. This is sometimes known as ozonosphere. In general, we can say the presence of O3 is very high in this stratosphere, which has been extending from 16 to 49 kilometer of the atmospheric layer. And the characteristics of the ozone is the harmful UV radiation radiating from the sun never allows or reflects it back towards the earth, because UV radiation is very dangerous, as it may causes various problems like cataracts, keratitis, skin cancer, chlorosis among plants, necrosis, and so many other problems. Depletion of ozone simply means we are using chemical substance from different purposes, like chlorofluorocarbons, hydrochlorofluorocarbons, carbon tetrachloride, chloride, freons, methyl bromide, and all these are collectively, we call these are collectively as ODS, ozone depleting substances. We are using for these for different purposes, either for refrigerators or for fumigants, as pesticides, as industrial solvents, etc. So after release of such chemicals into the atmosphere, the atmospheric ozone gets depleted or break down or get dissociated, and such dissociation of ozone results the easy penetration of harmful UV radiation to the surface of the earth, and it results so many problems as already discussed. Interesting to know, two different ozone we have. One is good ozone. good ozone and one is bad ozone. Ozone present in the stratosphere is good. Stratosphere is good, and ozone present in the troposphere is pollutant. Means as long as the ozone is present in the stratosphere, it protects us from being the damaging effect of the ultraviolet radiation. But as the ozone is present in the troposphere, then it may result so many disease among human beings and damage the properties, etc., etc. Next, we'll discuss climate change. Climate change. Let us have a look. What is climate? It has many parameters like temperature, humidity, precipitation, air mass, etc. And if we are considering temperature of any particular geographical area, if we are considering humidity of the particular area, precipitation throughout the year, be it in the form of rainfall, snowfall, hail, sleet, drizzles, etc., and the air mass of that particular area or the whole continent mass. Experiencing a heavy snowfall in Himalayan regions is the climatic characteristics of that particular region, and experiencing a heavier rainfall on the tropical areas and excessive humidity and arid conditions in desert areas are the parameters of the climate in a particular geographical area, and such parameters are not taken into consideration for a shorter duration of time for climate, but such parameters are taken into account for 30 to 35 years as per the World Meteorological Department organization or department. World Meteorological Organization says consideration or experience of parameters like temperature, humidity, precipitation, air mass of a particular region over a period of 30 to 35 years is the climate of that particular area. Similarly, if we are take the same parameters for a shorter duration, for a day, even for a small region, then we call the same parameter as weather. Weather means the same parameters are taken into consideration, but the difference is that it is for shorter period of time over a small area. And if the same parameters are taken account into a longer duration, then we call these as climate. Then climate change. Change, as you know, if we are supposed to experience a heavy rainfall in the month of November or December in the Himalayan regions, and if we are not experiencing heavy snowfall on the particular months as mentioned, November, December, January, and we are experiencing dry spell, means no snowfall, no rainfall, then we can call this a type of climate change. And experiencing of heavy snowfall in the months of June, and as we sometimes experience it in this very particular year, I must say 2020, we experience it heavy snowfall on 12th of June 2020, which we are not expecting as per the experience of our past, as our climate was not such type. And sometimes we are experiencing a dry spell of no snowfall even up to the month of February. So these are the changes. We are supposed to experience heavy snowfall in the month of February, but we are experiencing a dry spell. We are not supposed to expect heavy snowfall in the month of June, but we are experiencing a heavy snowfall in the month of June. Then these are the climate changes. What we are supposed to experience in a particular period of time in a particular area, but we are experiencing the contrasting things on such period of time in such areas, then we can call these or climate change. Then finally, what we are supposed to include the environmental issues is natural disasters. Natural disasters means the cyclone, earthquake, floods, tsunamis, forest fires, etc., etc. These are no doubt natural disasters are the disasters which have the control by the nature itself, but we can mitigate, we can reduce the impact of such natural disasters as and when occurs. Cyclones are there, earthquake is there, flood is there, forest fire is there, tsunamis are there. These are the natural disasters which are occur at a particular period of time, and we cannot sometimes predict these occurrences, but we can mitigate, we can reduce the impact of such natural disasters by taking some preventive measurements. As already discussed, we have policies and practices for reducing or for mitigating such environmental issues like natural disasters. So what we are supposed to do if occurrence of any natural disaster, say for example cyclone is there, earthquake is there, flood is there, tsunami is there, forest fire is there, occurrence of such natural disaster, then what we are supposed to do? We are supposed to implement, we are supposed to have a look the policies already formulated and practically implement such policies on the ground to mitigate, to reduce the impact of such environmental issues or natural disasters. Hope you must have understand the overview of these environmental issues. In the next very lecture, we will discuss all these environmental issues one by one as the syllabus demands. Air pollution, its causes, consequences, remedial measurements. So then water pollution, soil pollution, and all the pollution we are supposed to discuss in detail. In the next lecture, we will try to discuss air pollution, its causes, consequences, control measurements. Till then, stay home, stay safe, best of luck.